And now, the continuation of Hell's Kitchen.
Let's go.
Come on.
For tonight's dinner service, it's the biggest test both teams have faced so far. It's red menu versus the blue. But Chef Ramsay's critique of the blue team's dishes...
What is it?
Grilled quail.
Excuse me, there's bone everywhere. You didn't take the bone out?
...is a major setback.
I'm about to kick you out of here.
And Clemenza's careless and dangerous mistake has Chef Ramsay fuming.
You ready to go home?
No, Chef, I'll fix it.
That quail's a disaster.
Yes, Chef.
That needs some serious work on there.
Holy You know, I thought I was gone. I really, seriously thought I was gone.
Now, with only 30 minutes until the doors open, the blue team has their work cut out for them.
I want this menu absolutely nailed. Step up a gear a little bit. This is your menu.
Yes, Chef.
Let's go, yes?
All right, I will help inspect the quails and asparagus steak nonsense with that.
Yeah.
I'm really worried about the dishes. Before service starts, we have so much stuff to do. We got to get focused. We got to have our together.
He didn't say anything bad about the peaches.
I think you should oil, salt, and pepper those and just char them on the grill.
Okay.
These are all little easy fixes.
Let's go, ladies. Tonight's the night. I can feel it in the air. Let's go, Clemenza.
Yes, Chef.
Bounce around to the side. Let's go. Right. Okay, red team, blue team. Tonight is the night. It's the blue menu versus the red menu.
Girls better kill it tonight. We set up for success, so should be real easy tonight.
No excuses. Your stations, your menu, my standards. Got it?
Yes, Chef!
I don't think the red team is better than us at all.
I know that if we lose, it's just because we can't get our together.
There's no reason for it.
Okay, James.
Yes,
Chef. Open Hell's Kitchen, please. Red versus blue menu. Let's go.
Yes, Chef.
Tonight's dinner service, the Red Kitchen's menu will feature Christina's flatbread and Kimmy's ribeye with Tiffany's potato gratin. The Blue Team's menu will feature Justin's scallop stuffed squash blossoms, Justin's steak and fried onions, and Brian's sea bass.
I'm going to start out with the pizza.
Chef Ramsay will be using diner comment cards to help him determine the winner of tonight's dinner service.
And away, 4 covers, table 34. 3 flatbread, 1 beet salad.
Yes, Chef!
On order, 3 covers away, table 64. 2 beet salad, 1 flatbread.
Yes, Chef!
2 minutes, guys.
4 covers, table 50. 2 flatbread, 1 mussels, 1 beet salad.
Yes, Chef!
Going in. Right off the bat, I already have like 8 flatbreads fired.
2 beet, 1 flatbread. No answer.
2 beet, 1 flatbread.
4 minutes, please.
Speed up, young lady.
Yes, Chef. I was just like, why did we have to start this way? Can we talk it out, hug it out, anything, something? Give me some love, Chef Ramsay, please.
Beats out walking. Walking now with muscles.
2 flatbread, I'm dying. Christina.
90 seconds, Chef.
Come on, man.
90 seconds.
Hey, young lady.
Yes,
where's
chef.
Your vigor? Where's your
just
speed?
Yes,
changing
chef.
Gear.
Yes, Chef.
Where is it?
It's right here, Chef. Somebody, like, help me out, please.
All right, I'm gonna come over here and help with your flatbreads, okay?
Christina definitely talks a big game, but tonight, she's just losing it.
Thank you. I'm walking with 2 flatbreads.
Service, please.
With Barbie's help,
2 flatbread, Chef.
The flatbread crisis has been avoided, and Christina is sending full orders of appetizers to the pass. Meanwhile, in the blue kitchen, Robin,
excuse me, let me get the squash blossoms out,
is hoping to get her team off to a quick start by cooking to perfection Justin's squash blossom appetizers.
Are you sure they're hot?
Yeah, it's just not cooked up. Huh? It's too pink, man.
Hey, come here. Come here, Ollie. Stop. Just touch that. Just touch it.
Mushy.
Just touch it.
Justin's dish is a scallop mousse with chunks of lobster in there, piped in a stupid flour. Who the wants to eat a flour with mousse in it?
Hey, stop. Stop. All of you. I don't know what the hell is going on. All of you, this is your menu.
Yes, Chef.
Your stations, and you keep me standing there dying. Get in the game.
Yes, Chef.
Cook them all the way through. Cook them all the way through.
This is your dish. You told me 5 minutes, and now it's not 5 minutes, bro.
You never cooked before, feel the damn thing, and if it's ready, you send it up. I don't understand where the thought process is in it. Are you blaming somebody? Are you blaming me for that?
Actually, I am kind of blaming you, bro. Yes, I'm blaming you, Justin. You. You set me up for failure. I did exactly what you said, and the first order of squash blossoms came back raw.
Finally. I knew it was too good to be true. Now they're overcooked. Hey, touch them. They're like boiled to. Hello, touch them. Get a grip.
Get your head together.
I got my head. I need more squashes done, please. Hello, Justin, did you hear me?
Yeah, well, what do you want? I can't, what do you want me to do?
Robin, what the f- are you doing over there? Get yourself organized.
The only person that's gonna help you out here is yourself.
Madam.
Yes.
You're all over the place.
I'm making more, chef.
While the blue team struggles to get out of the blocks.
It's the first table.
Coming out right now, chef. Coming out right now.
The red team.
Two flatbreads, chef.
Okay, go.
Is blazing along, having sent out more than half of their appetizers.
Oh, that is so good.
Away now, yes, two halibut, one ribeye.
And are now ready with their first entrees.
Walking with two halibut.
That halibut's beautifully cooked.
Thank you, chef.
Good work, ladies. Let's keep it going,
keep
okay?
Keep it up.
Kimmy, do you need any help?
No, I got everything else. Thank you. I'm asking you if you need help and you don't want it.
Do you need any help with sauces?
No, no. Fine with me.
Pull the ribeyes out of there for me.
Barbie, you see these two badass fingers from Memphis? I can handle this. I don't need your help.
Hey. Oh, hello.
Yes, stop, chef.
All of you. Look, oh, that's the stunning, beautiful duck, by the way. Take a slice.
When chef makes you taste a dish, you know it's gonna be bad.
Take a slice. Take a slice.
It's overcooked, Kimmy.
Yeah, answer.
Overcooked, chef. It's dry, it's disgusting.
What the hell?
Overcooked and the fat's not rendered good. Bitch, shut the f- up. You don't need to be eating my food and telling me what's wrong with it.
Your menu, Christina.
Yes, chef.
Your menu.
I know, chef.
I offer. I can cook meat and duck.
We're coming right back, chef.
As Kimmy tries to nail the duck in the blue kitchen,
two crabs, two scallops. How long?
Follow right away. Okay.
Robin,
service, please.
Has finally figured out the scallop squash blossoms.
That's really good.
But some diners,
we don't have any more scallops.
That's all I got.
Maybe out of luck.
Chef, we don't have enough for that last order.
Justin didn't prep enough squash blossoms. So obviously, my faith in Justin has just went out the door.
We don't have enough scallops.
I prepped, I think, 20 orders, but she just kept it up. Give it raw, give it overcooked. So of course we didn't have enough. I'll take blame for when I up, but come on, really? I up there?
Go and get James.
Yes, I'll
take your ticket.
Yes, chef. Hi, folks. Unfortunately, we don't have the two scallops because they were undercooked them.
Okay.
But I can replace them with two more crab salads or two carpaccios.
This is mortifying, embarrassing, humiliating. I just want to crawl into a hole and die.
Oh, what would you
we'll
like?
The carpaccio.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. I do apologize again. Awesome. I'll have it right up for you. Here you go, chef.
Robin is having major issues.
It's not personal, but as a chef, she sucks.
Chef followed by the second order 6 minutes after chef.
Oh, man. Let's go.
With Robin's plan B in motion, the blue team is finally moving on to entrees.
On order, 6 cover table 22, 3 New York strip, 3 bass.
Yes, chef.
Meanwhile, in the red kitchen.
Behind you, chef.
Kimmy is ready with her second attempt at the duck.
Nice, that, no?
Yeah.
It looks lovely. Service.
Meat has to be on point with time.
I got it.
If meat fails, then garnish fails, then fish fails.
Where's the ribeye?
I'm walking right now. The rest of my duck came out perfectly, and I just gotta make sure I am on point or we're
it's overcooked now. We got overcooked ribeye.
It's all easy food, so if nobody can make it, then they shouldn't really be here.
I thought you cared.
I do, chef.
Yeah, so you just like, here you go, chef, here you go.
Kimmy, I hate losing dinner service. I'm like, ah!
At this stage of the game, your menu, my standards, that's not good enough. Giving up?
Forty-five minutes into dinner service, both teams have just about completed their appetizers.
Service, please.
And moved on to entrees.
Four ribeye.
Yes, chef.
But Kimmy's inconsistent performance on the meat station has Chef Ramsay's confidence completely shaken.
There you go. You giving up?
No, chef.
I swear to God, I don't give a f- if the whole team goes home tonight. I don't care.
I got you right now, chef. Oh. Me, dude. Confidence, Kimmy. Confidence. Because I know I can do it.
You giving up?
No, chef.
Look how flat it is. It's like we finished service. We're not even halfway through.
She's slicing.
Come on.
She's slicing.
Let's go.
Chef. Come on, let's push. Let's push.
Are the ribeye coming?
Walking now.
Chef, this is hot.
There you go.
Kimmy. That's beautifully cooked.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Service, please.
Kimmy has bounced back on the meat station, and entrees are making their way out to the dining room.
Everybody good? Keep talking. Keep it up.
Meanwhile, in the blue kitchen,
three New York strip, one sea bass.
Justin on meat.
Walking with the shrimp.
And Clemenza on fish.
Sea bass are up, chef.
Have come together to complete their first table of entrees.
Garnish in my hand.
Ryan, there's onions missing. They're not ready.
Forgot about that.
It's my bad. It's just not good.
Up, chef.
I can hear you. Mine's still on the slide. Oh, look at me. Look at me. Get in the game.
Yes, off. Yes, chef.
Okay.
I just completely forgot that they were even on the dish.
I'm not getting murdered on an onion ring. On a fried onion. That's not happening tonight. There's no way.
Get those onion rings up, guys.
Onion rings, Brian.
Garnish is up.
Oh,
stop.
Come here, all of you. Come here. Come here. Yeah, look, look. Hey, look. Touch them. Touch. Touch. Hold on there. Pass them. Pass it around. It's like a golf ball, look.
No, Chef Ramsay's not having that.
Damn me.
Look at me. You don't care.
I care, chef.
Hey, look at me. If you cared, you'd question what you're doing.
I seen a quab onion that he sent up.
Brian, come on. It's not rocket science.
How long? Right now, chef. In my hand. Onions are up.
Perfect. Service, please.
Garnished and ready for prime time, the blue team's first entrees have finally made it out to the dining room.
Oh, this is good. Yeah, I like it.
Meanwhile, the red team...
Walking with two halibut.
...led by Dana...
That halibut's beautifully cooked.
Thank you, chef.
...continues to push out entrees.
How is everything? Who's wrong? Lobster's wrong? To apologize.
But unfortunately, Maitre D. James has some disappointing news for Chef Ramsay.
They've all complained that it's raw.
Guys, like something's coming back. Please don't be mine. Please don't be mine.
Dana!
Oh my God, are you kidding me? Yes, chef!
You cook the halibut perfectly. Raw lobster. I mean, oh, come on. Honestly, look at it. I
yes,
trust
chef.
You with the main fish and you cook the lobster undercooked.
Yes, chef. I thought the lobster claws at my station were already fully cooked and all I had to do was reheat them in the water, but apparently that's not the case.
I mean, now. I swear to God, it's pinker inside than Paris Hilton's lipstick.
Yes, chef. Come on, Dana. That's not you. You don't make mistakes like that.
Dana!
Yes, chef. I thought they were cooked all the way through. It's my fault, chef.
Right back. The food have to be perfect, so I need to redeem myself and show that I'm strong in service.
Lobster claws?
Service, please.
While Dana's lobster leaves the kitchen for a second and hopefully final time, over in the blue kitchen...
I'm going in 2 minutes. You follow me up, okay? Yes.
Justin is more vocal than ever and takes the lead on entrees.
We're following right away with the entree, okay? You'll be right with that? Talk to me. Let me know. Get it ready.
You know, Clemenza makes me nervous sometimes.
He's very slow and lackadaisical. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Clemenza, you ready with the fish? Yes, talk to me.
Yes?
Clemenza, you okay with the fish?
Yes, yes, I'm good.
Okay.
Justin, I appreciate your help, but shut the f*** up. I don't need you to tell me how many we got. I'm just gonna keep making them.
Clemenza! That bass is cooked perfectly.
Thank you, chef.
Bam, how you like me now, bitch? You know what I'm saying? This ain't my first dog and pony show.
Service, please.
While entrees continue to leave the blue kitchen at Clemenza standard time...
Keep it up, Clemenza. Beautiful. Keep it up.
The red team...
Two duck, one halibut, one ribeye.
Walking now.
...seems to be back in the groove.
Service, please.
But one chef has a dirty little secret.
45 seconds on the ramp.
You're preparing fish garnish in a dirty pan. Oh, hello. All of you, I've just watched Tiffany scrape out all the old So she gets the dirty pan and sticks all the fresh garnish in there.
Tiffany is definitely a little gross. She's nasty.
When a chef can't be bothered to get a clean pan and saute fresh vegetables, trust me, it tells me something.
Sorry, chef.
We have 2 million
saute pans in Hell's Kitchen, and you're gonna pick up a dirty saute pan and cook in it. How gross is that?
Look at you.
While Tiffany tries to clean up her act in the Blue Kitchen,
2 C-Bus, 1 Quail, 1 New York Strip, followed by 2 C-Bus, 2 New York Strip.
Yes, Chef.
Justin.
Clemenza, you heard what he said?
And Clemenza.
What?
Can't seem to get their act together.
It's one and then two, one and then two.
2 C-Bus.
Yes, minute and a half on the bass.
He literally looked at me like deer in the headlights. Like, what the f*** are you talking about? Like, I just told you. Two and then two. Two and then two.
Clemenza, what's up?
Communication, it was kind of hard to hear over Justin's yelling.
We're walking in 1 minute.
Shut your mouth.
2 C-Bus, a clown in New York.
Clemenza.
Yes.
I'm going with the strip.
Yes, I'm ready. I'm ready.
Behind you.
Here.
One is missing on that.
Where's the second C-Bus?
I'm coming up with two right now.
Why is he bringing two?
One. One.
You're telling me one, he's telling me two.
2 C-Bus, 2 New York Strip.
What?
Come on, Clemenza, what the f***? I gotta fire another meat now.
Every table, stop, start. Stop, start, stop, start, stop, start. And all because you haven't got the balls to say, Chef, I'm dragging a bass.
I have the other C-Bus right
Where?
Here.
Where? Lying bastard, you knew if you hadn't got it. Why'd you do it?
I really don't understand you, Chef.
I will nail you to the post.
An hour and a half into dinner service, the blue team has only managed to serve half of their entrees.
One missing on that.
Leaving half of the diners waiting.
Where's the second C-Bass?
And thanks to Clemenza's confusion with the number of C-Bass on order,
I will nail you to the post.
They will continue to wait.
Can I just jump down there and get some food?
Clemenza, if you got the fish in the oven, why don't you give it to Brian and help her with dessert?
Clemenza, there's no option. We're not losing.
Fish is in the oven. 3.5 minutes. What do you need?
Give it to Brian.
While Brian tries to save the fish station, the red team has a ton of momentum and are almost done with entrees.
Thank you.
Unfortunately,
potatoes are raw.
Not everything is edible.
That roll.
First for me. Hey, come here. I might say come here. I mean, come here, look. Now we got some raw potatoes. No, we just touch them. Touch the potatoes.
Can we just get done without getting yelled at? Like, all I have to do is take my potatoes and put them into a pan. It's not hard.
That's the first time in my cooking career I've heard of a raw gratin dauphinoise. You've given up. She doesn't care.
I do care.
Oh.
Don't tell me that I don't care. I care about food more than I care about my family.
It so hurts! Your menu!
Back on your station, come on, guys.
Tiffany, I told you 5 hours ago that they were crunchy.
Potatoes aren't done. That's not a big deal. See what it tastes like when it cools.
It should have been in the oven for a lot longer.
I've been serving the same potatoes all night. No, all of a sudden I have a problem.
When you to me, you asked me and I said they were crunchy.
I put them back in the oven.
We're just like, there's no way to get around this.
You're gonna have to give me a little bit of time so I can cook these potatoes that were been put up already.
How long?
10 minutes.
While Tiffany's raw potatoes have brought the red kitchen to a grinding halt, in the blue kitchen, Justin,
walking with the strip, going to the window behind you,
is once again leading the charge.
Service, please.
Thank you.
And is determined to deliver the rest of his team's entrees.
They cook proper. No? Oh, man.
Come here! 3 New York Strip or medium. Virgin medium well.
The three that came back were like slightly over, like really slightly over. I was pissed at myself. Hell, I didn't want to overcook one prime steak. I was doing fine the whole night.
I'll be ready soon.
Justin, he thinks he's a head honcho, king, mighty, everything. Well, you know what, bro? You failed. Let's help each other out before we get in the weeds. That's the whole point of teamwork.
So how long? 28 minutes? Go on.
I was gonna say 6 minutes.
I guarantee it's not happening now when it should be happening.
The 2 Quail in the oven and 2 Bass are
ready. How long?
6 minutes, Chef. 6 minutes.
So why is it so long?
I don't know what happened with the fish and the quail, Chef.
Really?
Justin, you know what? Take responsibility from the time you started prepping until the time we sank like a Titanic. Own up, man up, and step up.
You're on. Let's go.
With diners on the blue side growing more hungry.
At least we have bread.
We do have bread.
And less hopeful, the red team is stuck on their last two tickets.
How long, Tiff? I don't know exactly.
Still waiting on Tiffany's undercooked potato garnish.
You should know they're your potatoes, right? That was your component, right? That was your idea for the menu, right?
I'm sorry, what do you want me to say? Don't give me that look.
Don't get an attitude with me, dude. You're just killing my steak.
I don't know, Kimmy. I don't know.
Tiffany.
Sorry.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
You're the floppiest cook I've ever seen my whole entire life.
Sorry.
No, you're not.
Okay, I'm not.
You have such a attitude. Why don't you take a walk and Dana take over her section?
Yes, chef. Have fun.
Hey, look at Tiffany. Let's make fun of her.
I don't care about anything, apparently, so what the f-? Y'all just made me look like an idiot. Bye. Come on, guys. Let's finish it out. Let's finish it out.
How long?
Potatoes are not ready. We're just waiting on the potatoes.
How those potatoes look, Dana?
No.
They're crunchy. So I add cream and I put them in the oven again and again. And again, and again. No matter how much I cook these potatoes, they are still crunchy. The last ticket.
Dude, you still aren't done.
In spite of being a couple of tables away from completing their service, the red team is stuck in neutral by the mystifying potatoes.
I told her they were mad crunchy, dude.
Meanwhile, the blue team, who have struggled all night,
last table,
is somehow at the finish line.
Get this last table off, come on, do it right.
Where's the bus? Where's the other bus?
The other bus? I just pulled it out of the oven. I don't like the way it looks. I think it needs more sear. I don't like it. I just want some color on top of it. I didn't like the color.
A little bit fish here, a little bit there. You're stuffing your face with dessert. Hey, yes, all of you, come here. Put that one down. Blind man can see that's raw, raw, raw.
It's my fault. It's my fault.
Honestly, your menu, your menu, your menu, your menu. You give me that, followed by that. You. Get out! Idiots. Get the out of here.
Hours into the red menu versus blue menu dinner service, neither team has impressed Chef Ramsay with the execution of their own dishes. And in the blue kitchen,
all of you, come here. You give me that, followed by that.
Brian's raw sea bass has finally pushed Chef Ramsay over the edge.
You. Get out. Idiots. Get the out of here.
I don't get it. We just got kicked out of our own kitchen. With our own menu, with our own dishes that we created. How much of a do I feel like?
Oh, come on, man.
I don't know what happened.
The fish wasn't cooked.
Why wasn't the fish cooked?
Because you didn't have it.
Because you didn't tell me.
Yes, I did. I said 2 and 2.
What the is going on here? I don't get it. I mean, I'm not saying that I'm perfect, but I mean, really? Like, I don't even, like, you think I'm wrong here?
But you kept saying I got 2 steak.
What do you mean? It was the second ticket.
You kept telling me this is what
you
need now.
No, I said that's the final ticket. The final ticket was 2 and 2.
But you didn't say that.
The one before it was 2 and 1. Yes, I did.
While the blue team plays the blame game, back in their kitchen.
Scott, 2 bussin, please. 2 New Yorks trip.
2 New Yorks are out and resting.
Chef Ramsay and Chef Scott complete the final table.
James, that's what they should look like. Go, please.
Thank you very much.
Meanwhile, in the red kitchen, Potato Gate is over, and the final table is now being served.
Okay, let's go.
The potatoes finally finish, and I'm like, oh, thank God.
That is not what I expected. Switch off, clear down, and off.
Well, at least we didn't get kicked out of the kitchen.
Oh, nobody's in there?
No.
They all got kicked out?
Yeah. Oh my God, I didn't know that.
It is always good news to hear that the blue team has been kicked out of the kitchen. At least we know we're not the losing team tonight.
All of you, listen carefully. I have in my hand the comment cards. I was hoping that they would decide the winning team. Tonight
It was the most shocking dinner service yet. Here's the sad news. Your menu, your creativity, your execution, and supposedly your teamwork. Blue team, embarrassing. I mean, really embarrassing. It's like you just didn't care. And ladies, raw potatoes. And then Dana, raw lobster. I expected tonight to be your absolute best. Unfortunately, it's gone down in history as one of your worst. There will be no winning team.
I'm so confused right now. Somebody, tell me what the hell's going on.
I don't even know what to say. Like, I really thought we had this.
Both teams, decide which two people you want to nominate to lose from your team.
We all bust our ass to get so close, you know, to put in such an effort to fall flat. But it hurts, man, it hurts.
Who wants to start? I say Robin. I'm saying Robin.
Justin, I did exactly what you said for the squash blossoms. It was your damn dish. I'm putting up you for failing me.
You know, if someone really needs help, that's one thing. If you don't know how to cook squash blossoms, that's your fault, not mine.
And what did Chef Ramsay say yesterday? Hold your own station down.
And ask for help, and I asked you for help. He's denied it.
I can't believe it. Robin cannot take responsibility for herself at all. She's a child. I'm not gonna sit here and babysit people.
You had no idea what was going on.
Do you know why? Because they were all different sizes.
No, what do you think? Every squash blossom grows the same size? You had your mind?
You set me up for failure, bro. As a leader, you should have set me up for success.
No one wants to hear it anymore. You hear anybody else make comments?
Justin, you know what? Have respect.
No one hears it.
Have respect.
No one cares.
No one cares?
You don't care, and he don't care. Romanza?
There's as much as I don't want to work with Robin. Justin scares me. I'm still kind of conflicted about the decision, but this is my chance to jump ahead for my competition and trying to send Justin home. I gotta say.
After failing to successfully deliver on the menus they designed, each team was asked to nominate two chefs. Justin and Brian have chosen Robin as their first nominee, leaving Clemenza with the last word.
I gotta say Robin. Even though Robin tried it, I'm not gonna put myself up.
Robin, you're an idiot. Get out.
Would anyone like to start?
We'll let you go first.
My first vote is for Tiffany, based on the potatoes, and then Kimmy kept saying, like, well, how long?
I told her 3 to 5 minutes. That's why I couldn't give you an answer, Kimmy. I didn't know. I got totally set up to look like these tonight.
She thinks she was set up. Set up? By who? Do you think that we came and took the potatoes out of the oven while you weren't looking? No, you cooked the potatoes. They're crunchy. That's it.
I'm voting for Tiffany and Barbie. I'm gonna vote Tiffany. Kimmy.
Barbie, because of how she wasn't prepped today.
What the has she been doing with 2 hours for these muscles?
2.5 hours now.
At her pace, we'll never get done.
You put us behind in prep. And your attitude
I did the lobsters.
You're gonna let me finish? Are you gonna interrupt me or are you gonna let me finish? You've been having this attitude all day with everybody.
I haven't said anything to everybody. I just have been working.
I feel like a little bit like it's not the things you say, it's like the looks that you've been giving people.
Are you serious? Are you serious? I'm getting nominated because I make faces?
Whew. Okay.
You said you're voting for Tiffany and Kimmy?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Tiffany?
What's the point? There's no point.
You have to.
Okay, Kimmy, no offense, and Barbie.
Okay.
Barbie doesn't deserve to be here. She can't cooperate with people. She says some about everyone. She's rude to everybody. She thinks she runs this place.
Christina.
I'm really having a hard time with my second vote, Barbie or Kimmy. Hey. Would I rather work next to somebody that's not talking, has a ton of attitude, or would I
rather work next to somebody that is in need of some direction and has a lot of questions. I don't know. It's too much great. I don't know.
Justin.
What's your second?
Clemenza.
I vote for Brian because he did up on the onion straws and the two raw sea basses.
What the?
Brian, you're up.
There's no way that Justin's gonna vote for Brian or Brian's gonna vote for Justin because they got this romance going on. I think they sleep on top of each other at night.
Clemenza.
I don't think I deserve to be up there. Absolutely, positively, no way should I deserve to be standing. I don't think it's me. He had raw onion up on a bunch of different, but I go up again. I don't think I deserve to go up.
Each of you have all had moments where you've shown me you can cook at a phenomenal level. And that's why tonight was so frustrating. Brian.
Yes, chef.
First nominee and why?
First nominee is Robin. She got hit pretty hard in the appetizers.
Yeah, I'll say. What's so funny, Robin? Help me to understand.
Because before service tonight, chef, I asked for help. And Justin's response to me was, if I don't have too much meat to sear.
What did you want me to do, chef? I'm not gonna spoon feed her.
Excuse me for one second.
I've never had to deal with turmoil on this team the whole time. Now I have to deal with this, chef, and honestly, I don't want to deal with this. I'm really embarrassed right now. Sorry, chef.
I'm embarrassed that we got thrown out tonight's service,
but I'm
just
still talking.
That's a leader?
Brian, second nominee and why?
Second nominee is Clemenza tonight, chef.
Clemenza?
Yes, chef. He had a few hiccups on fish.
Whoop the no.
During prep today, he got his ass handed to him a few times.
During prep?
During prep? I'm sorry, I find that a little offensive for you to point the finger at me because you're saying something that's just wildly bugged out to me. I had a dessert and I had two entrees.
Okay.
And the other two ideas were my ideas on the menu.
What the hell is going on right now?
After nominating Robin for elimination, the blue team's second choice is...
Clemenza tonight, chef.
Who is less than thrilled with his team's decision.
Yeah, I find that a little offensive for you to point the finger at me because you're saying something that's just wildly bugged out to me.
Oh, blue team. God, it hurts. Oh, boy. Christina.
Yes, chef.
Red team's first nominee and why?
First nominee is Tiffany, chef.
Tiffany. Why?
We hit a couple bumps throughout the night, but we felt like we could have pushed through it. The au gratin was cooked through, and that's what, you know, basically made us stop.
Second nominee, and why?
Second nominee was... Barbie.
Barbie.
It was based on prep today. We were working out a new menu and going from scratch.
So her prep was and that's why she's up for elimination. So, Barbie, over Kimmy, right?
Yes, chef.
Oh, dear. Tiffany, Barbie, Robin, Clemenza, step forward, please. Let's go. Tiffany.
Yes, chef.
Why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
I think that I'm a valuable team player to this team. I have no problem going in the kitchen every day and helping my team members out. I love working with these girls. I really enjoy being here, and I want to stay here, and I know I f***ed up on the potatoes tonight, and it's a huge mistake, and I feel so bad. And I just want to prove to you that I can do it, and
it's the passion, Tiffany.
I have so much
passion.
Where's
the desire?
There is so much passion
and desire. But there has to be a natural hunger to stand out in the red team, and right now you're not standing out. Barbie.
Yes, chef.
Why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
I think I should stay in Hell's Kitchen because I have been a team player.
They 100% want you out of here.
They've wanted me out of here since I've been here, chef. And I still want to be here because the only person who matters to me is you.
Clemenza.
Yes, chef.
You lied and you threw all of us under the bus, those last two tickets.
I have the other Seabass right
Where?
Here.
Where? Lying bastard, you knew you hadn't got it.
Jeff, if you want to stand here and call me an idiot or stupid, I can accept that.
But not an idiot, not stupid. You lied.
I did not understand what you said. I would not lie to you. I don't lie. It's not my character. You see, I say what it is to who it is for how it is.
Why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
Out of what went on tonight, I think I had the least of the problems on the team.
Robin.
Yes, Chef.
Clearly, you're not a team player.
I feel like I am a team player, Chef. And I'm sorry if you don't see that. I understand that I should be up here because I crashed on apps, but I came through and I fought through and I tried to fight harder.
It's not working in the red team and it hasn't worked in the blue team. One appetizer tonight, too cold, and you still went down.
I feel like I have a lot of heart and a lot of passion and I don't want to go home yet. I'm not ready to go home yet, but
there's nowhere else I can put you.
I feel like I'd be fine on the blue team. Whatever happens today is today. Tomorrow's a new day. I'm still going to come in the kitchen and work with them.
Okay. The person leaving Hell's Kitchen is... Tiffany. I'm sorry. I cannot see a leader in you. Please give me your jacket and leave Hell's Kitchen. Thank you. Good night.
Thank you.
I never thought I'd be kicked out of this competition this early. But Hell's Kitchen is harder than I thought it would ever be. Wish I could have made it to the top two. I tried my hardest. Chef Ramsay, I'm sorry that I didn't prove myself as a leader tonight, but I know that I am, and, you know, hopefully one day you'll see that.
Clemenza, back in line.
Thank you, Chef.
The two of you, back in line. Listen, and listen carefully. I want your best. Or I'm gonna start getting rid of you a lot quicker.
Yes, Chef.
I am not waiting any longer for you. I swear to God, I can't take any more. That's a warning. Now get out of here.
Yes, Chef.
Before Robin got here, the blue team never, ever argued about anything. Now we gotta deal with turmoil, schizos. Enough's enough. Go home.
Tiff, I'm fighting for you. It just sucks to see you go, but I'm gonna fight for you. I'm gonna get that bitch out of here just for you. I promise, Barbie's gonna be gone.
I didn't come here to make friends. I came here to win. I'm not giving up. I'm not gonna let this get to me. Even though they've tried to send me home four times, I'm still here. They can't stop me.
The most passionate I ever saw Tiffany was moments ago, when she was already on her way out. That was just too late.